All right, here's our thermal recording units. That's an example of one of them. We call them TRUs, T-R-U, thermal recording unit. You can see the lens in the ammo can, and the ammo can protects it from bears and from the weather, and it blocks the EMF. And we haul them into the woods, and that's what they look like after we've camouflaged them. All that shows is the lens. And we put them in logs and stumps and hillsides, and this is what we record. Wild animals in the forest living their lives. It's obviously a cougar prowling looking for some type of meat to eat. And you can see in the distance it's triggering the motion detection. A trail cam is not going to capture that image of that cougar. Here's another example of a cougar on a logging road. You can see its footprints. This is cool. This is a bobcat on the logging road, and it's locked in on something to catch. And there it goes, pounced, slow motion. It had to have jumped about 5 feet, maybe six. Don't know if it got it. But this is amazing. This is a, I believe it's a river otter. And that was a creek that it was walking along the side of. This is a bull elk with its antlers growing. They're glowing because the antlers are in the development stage and they have a layer of skin or velvet on them that carries blood and that keeps them hot as they grow. And this elk stuck around for 3 days. It started on May 31st and he finally left on June 2nd. And he just hung around in this meadow. He was the only one there. Nobody bothered him and nobody harassed him. He just hung out, got some alone time. Eventually he'll wander off, but he gets up, munches, lays back down, takes a nap. Just doing his thing. Stuck out the back leg there to stretch after a long nap, and finally he leaves the field of view. This is a bobcat. He's up on a log that we have the camera on. He jumps down into the ferns. He's prowling through, looking for something to catch, and then he poses for us. Looking good. This is a deer that's walking the road, and you can see it. It grabs a big bunch of something that was laying in the road. He's got a mouthful, or she has a mouthful, and I don't know what it was. It must have fallen from one of the trees, something that she liked to eat. This is included because this is an example of a deer that is pronking or stotting. They jump and they land on all four hooves and do it over a series of jumps. Here's another shot of a cougar. Whenever we get a cougar, we have to include it. This is a nice, fun video. It's a mama with a brand new fawn, and she's taking it slow and easy, letting the fawn keep up, letting the fawn get its legs under it. But she comes to the creek. You can see that's the darker area. That's the cold water flowing through the creek. And she's trying to figure out what she's going to do. And she jumps across. And the fawn is like, what? I can't do that. So mama fawn, or mama doe, is back on the fawn side. And the fawn is getting some nourishment. When it gets bigger, it'll be able to jump that creek. So here's a raven. It looks black, right? Because it has black feathers. Well, no, not in thermal. In thermal, the reason it's black is because it just got done taking a bath in the creek. There's another raven just showed up that's dry, and it's glowing white because it's giving off heat. And now the second arriving raven is going to go down and take a bath in the creek as well. This buck has antlers that are glowing white because they're growing and covered with velvet, which has blood flow. And he's just checking out the scene. There's an example of what our thermals can capture. That buck is at a long distance, and no trail cam is going to trigger on that type of a distance. Here's a coyote moving through the ferns, similar to what the bobcat was doing earlier, looking for something to catch. This is a doe blacktail moving through the field of view, followed by her fawn that she had this year, and they're followed by last year's fawn, which is a doe. Doe yearlings will often hang around with their mother a lot longer than if it is a buck yearling. And so that yearling got to hang out with her little sister. Obviously, this is a bear, and the woods are all uniform temperature because it's raining. Everything is soaking wet, and therefore everything looks the same temperature in a thermal. And this bear, you can tell his fur is sticking in clumps because he's drenched wet. And he's hopping up onto the log where we have the thermal camera located. And I'm glad that he didn't come and get closer and mess with the camera, because we've had bears mess with the cameras a few times. So here he is, like he might be auditioning for the circus, spinning around, showing his balance on top of the log, and maybe mooning us for putting a camera out in his living area. But he's an amazing, beautiful animal, giving us a full display. Now he's out of here. There's a long-distance shot of a doe blacktail, and she has a fawn. Ah, she has two fawns. They're twins. We'll keep an eye on them. They show up a few times later on. Here's that beautiful blacktail buck again, and he's kind of just a prop in this one. I put this in because the forest conditions are perfect for therming. They're dry, and the temperature differential is obvious to the smallest detail. And if anything walks through that field of view, we're going to see it. And the buck is just making it look good. Here's a coyote up on the log where the bear just was. And I think these animals like to get up on this log so that they can get a better view, because it's thick with ferns, and the ferns are almost 4 feet tall. And especially like this coyote, he gets down into the ferns and he can't see anything. And so they like to get up on the log so they can survey the area and figure out what's going on. This is hilarious, this video. That's a deer moving through the woods to the left. And now it's going to come back to the right, and look where the arrow is pointing. Here's a slow motion shot of it. It's another deer. There's head and ears. And then it goes heels over head and does a somersault. And it takes off trying to catch the other deer. They're having a serious game of tag. This is a long range shot of a bear, black bear, on the left side of the screen there. And he's jumping around checking out something. But again, the trail cam would not pick that up. This is a nice shot of two barred owls, hanging out looking for rodents to catch. This is amazing. This is a barred owl going in for a landing to eat its prey that it just caught. But look to the left of it, right there. It dropped its catch. Its catch is now dropping, and now the owl is going back down to get it, trying to follow it down. And now look at where the arrow is. You can see the mouse or the rat, whatever it caught, is taken off. It lives to see another day. There's a blob of black on the bottom left on the log, and this is a slug. This is the first time we've recorded a slug moving with thermal camera. I've got it fast forwarded, obviously, so that we can see him move. This is a doe moving into the scene, and she had to go to the bathroom. So if you ever wondered how doe blacktails urinate, well, there you go. They do a little squatting motion, and she apparently had a full bladder. There she is. Here's a nice big buck. Remember the bull elk that hung out in the meadow forever? Well, this guy isn't quite as bad, but he hung out in this field of view for a long time. And I fast-forwarded it so we could watch him do all his things, but not take forever. But I think he can smell the residue of when we were there putting the camera in place. And he's just checking things out. We need to be more careful with our scent control, looks like, on that one. Here's a big bobcat walking down the road. That's a big animal for a bobcat. There's Mama Doe and her twins. Twins are getting bigger. Hanging in there. Growing, learning. Must be a good mom. Here's a nice shot of a black bear moving through the field of view. Checking things out on the trail. And then something spooked him and he's running off to get away. There's doe and wait for it. It's nice that we were able to see her at this long distance. It's quite impressive. And there they are. It's the twins. They're getting big enough to cross the creek easily. And this is an amazing shot through thick foliage. This shows what thermal can do. A normal trail camera would never see this bear. But with thermal, you can see the bear through the foliage. Here we have a young buck and a big boss buck, blacktail deer, and they're sizing each other up. The big boss buck is basically showing the young one that you can't take me, and if you'll stay away from my does, we'll get along just fine. The boss buck is sniffing on the young one to get his scent. Meanwhile, the arrow is showing a small rodent moving through the grass, trying not to get stepped on by the deer. And there's a doe in the scene as well. And the bucks are kind of sizing each other up. And the older buck is letting the younger buck know he's in charge. All right, thank you for watching. That concludes this thermal video review.